Well, the next heat then, the United States side, John Drummond. He's the first of their quartet, but there's the British team, and there's Tony Jarrett, who had such a disappointment in the hurdles. He fell. Braithwaite, Campbell and Dacko making up the quartet, the Bahamas, the Wells, Stiles, Lewis and Tynes. Then the Swedes, Carlson, Eriksson, Hedner and Strenius. And the team from Qatar, I can't see them, they've clearly withdrawn. So the American quartet. John Drummond reached the semi-final here, but that's how they line up. He wasn't well and didn't go through to the final of the 100 meters. He's been running well in the season. He had a stomach upset and didn't make it. And Dennis Mitchell has got the fourth leg. Mitchell usually runs the third leg. He was fourth in the 100 meters in 9.99, and usually the fastest sprinter gets the last leg. So, Fiji in the second lane. No one in lane one or in lane eight. So Fiji, the United States, Thailand, Great Britain, the Bahamas, and Sweden. Jarrett has gone off very quickly with Drummond inside him. Drummond's made just a little bit up on Tony Jarrett. And the change very, very, well, steady, let's say that. Braithwaite down the back straight. For the United States, it's Tim Harden, who was fifth in the American 100 meters championship. That's a good change by the Americans, it certainly is. And Britain in trouble a little bit, I think. They've gone out, and I thought there was a problem, and it's a serious problem. They've gone. The Swedes coming through behind the United States, and the Bahamas coming in third. But the United States and Sweden, and 38.58, and Dennis Mitchell celebrates once again. Well, we'll catch up with the British quartet. All sorts of problems there. Braithwaite, Darren Campbell, over on the far corner of this stadium, and Owusu Dacko didn't even get a chance. Well, the British team in real trouble. There's Darren Campbell on the left, Dacko on the right, and a look of total and utter frustration there. And in contrast to the aggressive look on the face of John Drummond and Mitchell, they look very, very aggressive, don't they? Look at the look on their faces. This is the first round.
I was about to say, this is only the heat, so a semi-final and a final to come. But on paper, I suppose the United States, the favourites to take this 4x100-metre relay. They've done it so many times before and set world records. The existing world record, of course, by the United States 4 years ago in Barcelona. So a very experienced squad, but the British squad there, desperately disappointing.
Well, the problems for the British quartet, after all the practice, looks again, and finally drops the baton. And that was absolutely dreadful between Darren Braithwaite and Darren Campbell. It was as if they'd never met each other before. The American quartet on the third leg, Tim Montgomery to Dennis Mitchell, and the Americans were clearly away. The United States, the defending champions from 1992, they had problems in the World Championships last year and didn't feature in the final. But the United States, very, very competent on this occasion. They normally just rely on the sprinting speed of their competitors, but I have to say that they've done obviously a little bit of work on their relay change. Safe, very, very safe indeed. And the acceleration on that bend. pleasure to see, really. And now Mitchell, hand out, off he goes. Brilliant change. No one's going to catch Dennis Mitchell with that sort of lead on the final leg. But the problems for the British team in 4 by 100 meter relay running continue, and well, the coaches will be so disappointed with that. Britain, just looking back to the result of the last Olympic Games 4 years ago, they were fourth in that championship. Well, let's have a look at the British quartet. Tony Jarrett, well, he fell in the hurdles, didn't get through to the final. He's had such a difficult season. Drummond took a little bit out of him on this first leg, but then Darren Braithwaite was the receiver on the second leg. We'll see how that one goes. A shout, not particularly good. The arm should be fully extended, and it's baton speed that matters in relay racing. Now, this is the one. It's Braithwaite to Campbell where the problem occurs. There will be a visual mark for the outgoing runner. There'll also be an incoming runner who's shouting and screaming if things are not going to plan. There goes, shouting already. And Campbell is out far too long. Campbell went off too early. Absolutely clear, and he's actually stopping. And because he's stopping, he doesn't collect the baton, and it's gone down. And that was a total and utter mess. There's the baton. It didn't get round. And poor Owusu-Deko, who was eliminated in the early stages of his competition in the 200 metres, he didn't even get a chance. The United States and Sweden, the two qualifiers, 38.58 and 39.02. Britain should have qualified there. Not particularly special time, 39.02. Bahamas in third place, Thailand in fourth, and Fiji in fifth. We haven't seen the first heat result. We'll have a look at that in a moment, but already we've had incident, and you really think at the beginning of a 4x100 metres relay that things will go well. But it was a different British quartet, really, and not so experienced. There's the result of the first heat. The Ukraine 38.90 and Brazil 38.97. Just the first two to go through by right, and the six best times over the heats. There are five heats in the men's. That was readjusted today.